Das ist Kate. Kate from katenoyelu.com. KateNoyelu.com. Alright, so today we're going to be talking about Pinterest account audit. Alright, so if you're new to this channel or you haven't subscribed yet, click the link, subscription button, I don't know, here or there. Click that, subscribe, and click on the bell button so you know when I put out new videos. Alright, join my group so you don't miss anything about social media marketing, landing page, sales funnel, like a lot. Okay, join it. The link is below. Facebook group. Right, so I'm gonna be sharing the video of how I audited Michelle's Pinterest account. So sit back and enjoy, and if you have problem with your Pinterest, learn from this video and fix it. All right.
Hey Michelle, so auditing your Pinterest page, MoneyTech 1. Okay, so with MoneyTech and more, I'm looking at the title right now. I'm thinking maybe we gotta change something. Money is a keyword, tech is a keyword, yeah. But I want it to be more descriptive, like kind of like giving, telling you what you're doing, kind of. Think about what people search, you know, like saving money or making money online, you know, and all that. So let's search for like make money online or saving you money. I don't know, I'm just gonna search for what other Pinterest users are using, and let's see what pops out. So search, yeah, so let's go to all pins and look for people. Okay, so people. See, boom, see, so we got 38.8. we have like this lot, 16.5k, we have even more. So like as you can see, that's more like where the money is. So that's like a lot of following these people here, you know. So I think that's a good one. How about this guy and the wife or girlfriend? Okay, see, the serving couple, budgeting, saving money, make money online. So yeah, that's one thing I want us to look at. Maybe we'll say saving money, right, or make money online instead of just having money on your page. Just an idea. So maybe like make money online or saving money. So think about it. And so make money or saving money, comma, right? Tech, I want us to see if we can change that. Let's see what we can do. Maybe like be tacky. I don't know, tacky. That's crazy. Okay, let's see what that shows. Let's just research. Yep, let's do that. So be tacky. I don't know. Let's see what it gives. Why search? So, oh, we got something though. We got something. Well, let's get people. Okay, what do you notice? They all have zero followers. This is not where we want to be. Okay, I guess we gotta look for something different because this is like zero. I don't want to be among this group. It's changing. Let's see. Okay, tech tips. Let's see this one. It's already on people, so let's see what happens. Boom, yeah, 1.k, 4.9k, 9k. So like this is, it's not bad of a place to be, right? So that makes sense. So maybe you can change the title to like make money online, comma, tech tips, comma, and more, or save money. I don't know what I saw there. I think it's save money. Saving money. Oh no, yeah, it's saving money. So you can put saving money, or you say make money online, tech tips, and more, right? Okay, so now we're gonna you're missing description. So your page should describe what the page is all about. So like sharing tips on how to save money, or how to make money online, depending on which one you choose, tech tips, and more. Excuse me. And more. So think about that, and I want like at least 3 to 5 long-term keywords. I want you to use long-term keywords on this, so you can attract more people. So let's go to bots. All right, let's see all bots and see how your bots looking. All right, off the bat. Awesome. Beans from all over. That's not like keywords. Yeah, like, and most of your pins on this board are like tiny house and all that. So maybe you can change the awesome pins from all over to maybe like let's see, maybe like house decor. I don't know. Yeah, and you're also missing description what this board is all about. You know, like I told you on the main page, or each board, sorry, need a description as well. So maybe we can change this board from like awesome picture from everywhere, just see everything about. Sorry, or maybe just see home, tiny home decor, or like all my kitchen. I don't know, but we need to pick out a topic or title for this blog, like awesome pins for all from all over. If you search that, we're not gonna see anything, right? So we gotta figure out like what are we gonna do with this pin. Or we clean it up a little, since we have 90% of the picture in here, or the pins in here are more like house, kitchen, decor, you know, beds. So maybe we can do something like, you know, tiny house, right? I don't know. Okay. How about the trendy on Pinterest? Well, see, you have the same thing that you have on the other, on the last board that we just checked out, and more. So it's more like decor, house, room, bedroom, setting, and all that stuff. So maybe we can take a look at, let's see, how about we name this board something different? See, I know the trendy can be, it can be, but let's see if we can name it something different. Let's see, like Bohemian bedroom, yeah, Bohemian bedroom decor. So that's not a bad, that's not bad to like, you know, pick, because as you can see, it fits well with everything that you have. So if you want to go with the Moroccan style, or the boho DIY, but I think just stick with the Bohemian bedroom decor, because it's more like general, so it gives you more room to, you know, post anything that have connection with the, yeah. So let's stick with that one. Maybe do that. I'm not, oh, I'm sorry, I went back, I went to my page. So I'm not telling you like change it, but it's just my suggestion. Okay, let's see. So yeah, also when you pick a topic for this page, remember to put description. So home accessory and decor. I like this one. This is more like descriptive, and it, you know, it has like the keyword. People look for home accessories, people look for home decor. So this page is perfect, but it's missing the description. All right, so just put description. I like how this page is, but one thing I want to know is when you're creating boards, create boards that will be useful to you. What are the things that you talk about most on your blog, or what is your website all about? Okay, so create boards based on that. Okay, let's look at this one. Cheap and healthy food. Okay, Now, on the description part, I want you to think about what do you mean by cheap? That's where you come to explain, right? So think about that. Let's see what else we have here. Excuse me. Okay, blogging pins. Actually, let's go to blogging pins. Oh, let's see if I can figure out something else. Okay. You must have apps, you must have. Okay, let's do this one. All right. This app, apps you must have on iPhone, it's descriptive, but it's way too long, and I don't think people search for something like this. Maybe we can try something. Let me copy. Maybe we can do apps, iPhone apps and Android apps. Let's see what we got here. Oh, another option might be like, saying must have iPhone apps. So let's see what are the posts that you have under here. Okay, let's copy and let's search. I want to know if it comes up with apps that have really that related to iPhones and Android. Okay, actually, yeah, it has pulled things that has that are related to your the title. Okay, so let's see something. I want to figure something out. Let's see. iPhone. Let's see something. I just want to figure out something else. Maybe that will work. Let's look for iPhone apps. See, I think I saw maybe one of your posts. I don't know, but I'm not sure. But like, iPhone apps. I don't have the S there, but that's what I mean. Or you see, must have iPhone apps and Android apps. So that's one thing to think about. But like apps you must have on iPhone and Android doesn't sound like something people will search. So app, take out the apps you and on, take it out. So we have just must have, okay, must have iPhone apps and or just say must have iPhone and Android apps. Yep, and apps. So must have iPhone and Android apps. That would be great. And think about description as well. Okay. That would be great if you have description and put keywords. That brings people to your page, like a lot of people to your page. Okay, so let's see. I think the pink one is your, yeah, the 5 tip thing is your pin, right? That's your pin as well. And the reason why I don't know which one is your pin is I'm not sure of what is your website. Okay. So I'm still, is it Morganio or Monison? I don't know what your website is. And I think this is a group board. So you only have 2 people in that group. So the same thing. All right. So I want to make sure I know what your website is. But I have an idea of like what your post, your personal post looked like. Okay, financial independence. I actually like this board, so I'm thinking this pin is yours. This one, how to make money blogging. So I like the title, and remember, like all this, it might not be enough. Like use up all the, whatever number of words that Pinterest gives you, make use of all of it until it says you're over. Like don't waste even one single letter. Like use it all up and make sure you have keywords, like 3, 4, 5 keywords in it. You know how people search for things. You know how you type things on, because actually Pinterest reads all this, so they want it to look like what humans can read. You know, not just having keywords in there, but putting something that, you know, makes sense to humans. So put it like you're making a sentence, like, you know, I teach you how to make money online, or, you know, like, I don't know, just think about something. But this is just an idea. You need description anyways. So yeah, we talked about all this. Remember to change the title if you want to, and always have description and have keyword that brings people to your page. All right, I'm thinking of another board that we can, one more board that we can look at. I don't know, let's see. The life tips and hack is great. This money management pin, money, make money and save money. This is like perfect. There's like long tail keyword. So make money management and all that. I love it. So this one is good too. Apps for phone and tablets. I like that. So that's more like good one. So remember your to add descriptions. All right. So now I want you to see we're missing the website. Just okay, look at mine. See, I claim my website. I want you to claim your website as well. Because when you claim your website, I know which pin is yours. Like Pinterest will always link your, like, it doesn't matter what you pin, Pinterest will relate it. Like, they already know what your website is all about. They know who has, like, who owns that pin. So here is how you claim your website. Let me see if I can remember. So I have two Pinterest, one for my kids, the Boss Beauty, the other one is my bridal. So we go to setting, see claim there. We click on claim. So here, Pinterest will give you a space for you to type in your website and click claim. It's gonna be red when you do that. Mine is clear like this because I already claimed it. So you see how the Etsy and YouTube is down here, it's red. That's how yours is gonna be. So I claimed my Instagram, but I didn't claim my YouTube and Etsy. So let's go back to your page. All right, so you need to claim your you need to claim your page. I think that's all about it. All right.
So, what do you think? I hope you learn a lot from this video. All right? And if you have problems with your Pinterest or you think you're not growing as much as you should be, please go through this video again. Learn. Always have long tail keywords because that helps your page grow and be searchable.